it does not appear there. So this is one of the purpose of yoga, is to give you a totally integrated personality, where you start with awareness, where you start understanding things as they are, not as they appear. See, behavioral reality is something, but ultimate reality is something else. In behavioral realities, all is based on your language which you have developed. That may not be final truth. On behavioral aspect, you may call a chair as a chair. Someone would come and tell if these are the pieces of wood put together. Someone may say, no, it is a part of a tree. Further, someone say, no, it is a product of a sheet. So the language always will have contradiction. Experience will never have contradiction. And yoga talks of that experience. That is why you take up any sutra. He is so mathematical, very rational. Patanjali doesn't promise you anything which cannot happen. You do this, this will happen. A very systematic. He takes the total personality into consideration. He speaks of our behavioral aspect, our interpersonal behavioral aspect, your physical aspect, your respiratory aspect, your senses. Then, on one hand, he speaks what you should do, what you should practice. That he calls Bahirang Yoga, external yoga. Then he comes to Antarang Yoga, Dharana, Dhyana and Samadhi. That is internal yoga. This you cannot do. Remember this also, the difference. Concentration, meditation and integration. This you cannot do. It has to happen as a result of your practices. Many times we get confused with the meditational